Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs, and in this class I will be dealing with a very important topic, that is blockchain technology. Now this topic is important from GS mains paper 3 point of view. This is a part of science and technology topic. Now the present age is the age of data. The present age is the age where the data is treated nothing less than a gold mine. The value, the use, and its importance is increasing day by day. And most of the data that is getting generated, it is being stored on the servers. And this entire cyberspace in which it is being stored can be easily punctured, can be easily inflicted an injury by stealing data from it, or by editing the data, or by deleting certain data. Any addition, any deletion, or the theft of the data can cause a lot of loss to the organizations, to the institutions of whose data is being tampered with. So it is important that we should be able to protect this data. Now this data protection is also important because of late the governments, they have also begin to use this cyberspace. In India we have myriads of government programs that are running using the cyberspace, using this internet technology. So we need to provide a kind of a protective layer to internet. We need to provide a protective layer to how the transactions are carried out through this internet space, through this cyberspace. There is a need to provide a kind of a shield to the cyberspace. Now the countries over the world, they are trying to develop a technology which can act as a proof to the tampering of the data, to the theft of the data, to the addition of the data, or the deletion of the data. Now new technology has come to fore, that is a blockchain technology. Now this technology involves two critical components. Now the first critical component is a component of encryption, and the second critical component of this technology is the component of decentralizing data. Decentralizing data. Now in blockchain, what is meant by block? Block means you are actually dividing the information. You are actually dividing the data. And you are just trying to connect the data placed at different places through a chain. So the entire data that is stored is interconnected and it is open to everybody. Now when data is open to everybody, you might think that it might lead to the insecurity of the data, but this is actually not the case. When the data, it is not the data that will be open to everybody, it is only the digital signatures. Important keyword here, it is the digital signature that will be generated if we will store the data in a particular computer, if we will carry out a particular transaction. So whenever a kind of activity will be done, suppose a transaction will be done, suppose a good is moving from India to Africa, then the information about the transaction will be added in the blockchain data. When you will add the information, then that information, by the use of the encryption technology, will get converted into a particular digital signature. So the entire information, entire ledger of the data that will be available to everybody, it will not be the exact data, but it will be the data existing in the form of the digital signatures. And the original data will be encrypted. After encryption, it will take the form of a digital signature. Now, if somebody willing to edit, somebody willing to add, somebody willing to delete certain information, will actually also be bringing about a change in this digital signature. And whenever a change will be brought about in this digital signature, it will send emergency signals. And when it will send emergency signals, then one can know about the tampering of the data, the theft of the data. So the number one component about the blockchain technology is about the encryption of the data. And second is about decentralizing data. So any kind of data that will be generated, suppose the transaction will be carried out. Suppose the data about the Aadhaar card, people using this Aadhaar card information for having access to the employment stored in a particular computer will be there. Suppose the data about the applicants applying for UPSC 2007. So this entire data that will be generated, it will be in the open. It will be in the decentralized form. Now, what is meant by decentralized? Decentralization. Now, decentralization here means that the people, when they will be carrying out certain transaction in the form of, suppose you're buying something, suppose you're selling something, suppose you are having access to some service, in that case, you will be generating data. And that data that you will be generating, it will take the shape of a digital signature after getting encrypted. And why it is decentralized? It is decentralized because you are also adding certain information to the entire web of the digital signatures. Now, the digital signatures around the world, they will be existing in a certain pattern. And these patterns will be formed once you have done a transaction. So in case you want to alter this digital signature, or you want to change this digital signature, you cannot actually do it. You cannot tamper with the information, because if you will be trying to tamper, the digital signature will be changed. So basically, blockchain technology is a kind of an open ledger that everybody can see. Like, what goods are being bought, by whom, and from where. You can check the veracity of everything. Now suppose I import these board pens, whiteboard pens, from United States of America, and I just want to check whether these pens have been made in USA or not. Now using blockchain technology, I will enter the number of this pen in this data to find from where this pen has actually been imported. So this will also, this blockchain technology, first of all, is decentralized way. Everybody will have access to it. Everybody can participate to it. And this will be a kind of a transparent thing that will be existing. Then there will be encryption. The digital signatures will be there. Now anybody who would want to tamper with the information, edit the information, delete the information, or steal the information, will have to have access to all the computers where the information would be existing. And the information would be existing in the millions and the billions of the computers. And this is practically impossible to alter information by visiting all the machines, because the data will be visible. You can edit it on one computer, but the data, it being open to everybody, it will send the sign of emergency, the sign of data tampering, the sign of data theft to everybody. So it is easy to protect data. So blockchain technology is a technology that has recently been used by the Andhra Pradesh government in order to protect this Aadhaar data, the PDS data, and the data for the various governmental policies that the government has come out with. It can be used in agriculture insurance policies. It can be used in awarding benefits to the people in the welfare schemes. So this has got multiplicity of uses. So this is all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.